Well, today is interesting because I'm actually starting something new. So what I decided to do is I'm actually going to do a $5,000 small account challenge. I'm only trading the ES, and normally I only trade the NASDAQ, but I watch the ES. So it's kind of fun because I don't even remember the last time I took a trade on the ES, but just kind of trying to push myself a little bit and have some fun with it while also having a capped risk throughout the rest of the year. But let's go and get into the recap on the day. I took a few trades on the ES. Very first thing to note, markets are already open. We did not talk about pre-market levels. We'll talk about it in a second. Second thing to note, you'll notice that I'm on H contracts, right? I rolled over to March. This week is going to be crazy. That was the other thing. There's so many things to talk about today. This week's going to be crazy. Nothing really today on the books necessarily. Tomorrow we have CPI in the morning. That's big. Wednesday we have FOMC stuff, the last ones of the year. That's massive. Thursday we get some jobless claims. Friday we get PMI. And it's like triple witching or whatever. So like this week, it's kind of a heavy hitter week. So just be prepared. There are lots of news. Second off, we talked about a small account challenge in some capacity. I was like floating the idea. I didn't know if I wanted to do it or not. What I'm going to do is I'm going to trade only the ES. And I put $5,000 in an account. But I think I just like, I want to do something. And so I kind of want to do something that's like fun, a little bit challenging, new, etc. And this is kind of the thing that I thought of that fit the bill. So who knows? All right, coming into 76, that's the most interesting area that I have on the ES right here, where that block is basically. That block is now at 74. Still interested in this long though, if I can get filled. Point of control just came down a little bit. I'm also curious to see how long it takes me to get filled on, filled and exited on stuff if I'm actually limiting in. That was not too bad. That was pretty quick. Now we see if it just stays nice and heavy or if we get the kick back up. Because like there's so much depth on these. I feel like on exits, trying to have like a top tick exit on a wick or something would just be very hard on the ES, but like I said, I don't know. NAS is significantly through VWAP, nice and heavy, failed to break the highs. ES is trying to get it nice and heavy. We'll see if it stays or not. Are we rolling over to go back down and trade the 60s is the question to me. So far it feels choppy, but it's the first little bit of good movement. The NAS looks like it wants to go back down and trade into the 50s. But it's TBD. That's a double bottom that probably floats through. Don't really want to be holding with that double bottom there on the ES. 83 and a quarter is the wick test. But it just looks, the NAS just looks heavy, like way heavy. And it's been looking heavy because it failed to break the overnight highs while the ES did it. There's the double bottom repair on the ES. With the quick sweep to the upside off of it. Yeah, I think 78 and a half makes a lot of sense also, but everything's kind of heavy feeling, so I want to probably kill this earlier than that. And there we go. That's the very first official trade on the 5K S&P challenge, plus 125. I got to figure out, like, is the ES, like, very much more, like, level appreciative than the NAS is? You know, that type of thing is what I got to figure out. And I think it will be interesting for you to see, like, how much money does it actually require. Oh, say hi. Say hi. I don't remember what I was saying. It doesn't matter anyways. Okay, this is a great example of ESness. Where on the NAS, it's typically you kind of get filled here on the NAS on that type of push. But I've been sitting for a while and I still wasn't the first one. I don't know how many contracts traded up here, but obviously not that many. Nice little quick flush. I mean, that's the whole trade I wanted too. I wanted 82 down to like 78, 79, 78. Down to point of control. I think that it's still valid because I want to see what happens with the NAS and VWAP as well. Should get filled here. Okay, I'm in. Got 2 minutes left on this candle. I have my stop at new highs on the day. Kind of liked looking at this on the 1 minute. Pretty easy to see right now. I think this VWAP is wrong on the 1 minute. Huh? Little excess. Trying to push out of it. Last minute of this candle. Now it's back above VWAP. Pushing to 98 looks pretty decent. And I've stopped out. That's new highs on the day on the ES. Gross P&L up $3.78, baby. But I think this stop out, the trade, the stop out, all of that is like, how can you not take that? How can you not take something that's at the top of the range that's been getting rejected over and over and over again? Use the MACD on the ES. I'm not interested in using the MACD on the ES. Keep losing then. Okay. Oh man, that's when you know someone's thought process is very skewed. If you say you're not going to use something, they immediately just say, okay, fine, enjoy losing forever just because you don't use my one concept, my one theory. It's got to have some sort of psychological name attached to it. Just trade the opposite of Kramer and you'll be a millionaire in no time. Yeah, you see Kramer called for everybody to sell their crypto again and everybody's like, crypto's about to bottom now, yay. I do get kind of spooked by the quick open to the upside. But we at least kind of got a little bit back out of it, too. I'm just killing that there. I think I'm going to kill the stream here. I'm not super juiced on this movement right now. I'm up $12. It's a burrito without guac.